calm a cloud sees. The road was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The highwayman came riding up to the hill. He had a French cocktail on his forehead, a bunch of lace on his chin, a coat of and breeches of brown doe skin. They fitted with never a wrinkle, his boots were up to the thigh, with a jewel twinkle, his pistol buds a twinkle, his rapier hilt a twinkle under the jeweled sky. And over the cobbles they clattered and clashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip, the ball was locked and barred. Whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the black-eyed daughter, Bess, the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back before the morning light. Yet he would press me sharply, hurry me through the day in the moonlight. Watch for me by the moonlight. I'll come to thee by the moonlight. The hill should bar the way. He rose upright in the stirrups. He scarce could reach her hand, but she loosened her hair in the case, whispering like a brand. As a black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he kissed her. Oh, sweet waves in the moonlight, and tugged to this rain in the moonlight, and galloped away to the west. Out of the tawny sunset, before the rise of the moon, when the road was a gypsy's ribbon, looping the purple moon, a redcoat troop came marching, marching. King George's men came marching up to the olden door. They said no word to the landlord, they drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of a knight. Two of them nailed to the casement with muskets at the side. There was death at every window, hell at one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road he would ride. Tied her up to attention with many a sniggering jest, they had bound a musket beside her with a barrel beneath the breast. Now keep good watch, and they kissed her. She heard the dead man say, look for me by the moonlight, me by the moonlight. I'll come to thee by the moonlight, the hill should bar the way. Hands behind her, with all the knots in good, she writhed her hands till her fingers were wet with sweat. They stretched and strained in the darkness, and the hours crawled by like years, till now when the stroke of midnight called on midnight, the tip of her finger touched it, the trigger at least was hers. Whose ring clear, toward a long distance, where they deaf, they did not hear. Down the ribbon of moonlight, over the brow of the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The red coats looked to the priming, she stood up straight and still. Toward a lot in the frosty silence, toward a lot in the echoing night, nearer. Her face was
eyes grew wide for a moment. She drew in a last deep breath and moved in the moonlight. Her mask had shattered the moonlight, shattered her breast in the moonlight, and wound him away. He turned his spur to the west. He did not know she stood, but with her head drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it, his face grew gray to hear. Up as the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched for love in the moonlight and died in the darkness. And back he spurred like a madman, shrieking a curse to the sky, with a white robe smoke and his rapier brandished high. Blood red with the spurs of the golden moon, wine red with his velvet coat, when they shot him down on the highway, down like a dog on the highway. And he lay in his blood on the highway, with a bunch of lace in his throat.
Riding up to the hill.